The CAAMA Music Show.
Boom! There was a lightning strike!
Live music sessions.
Like Sharky.
Yeah.
And Goosebumps.
Oh, you know. Little Birdie told me you was in the CAAMA Music Studio.
Wanna play
I think we've got a massive amount of talent here.
All around Central Australia.
Sounds deadly. Boom. Boom.
Boom.
That's us on CAAMA.
Welcome back to the CAAMA Music Show this week. We have the one and only Bumpy here in the CAAMA Music Studio. So your mob, Bumpy is an award-winning Noongar woman and Naarm-based artist. She has wowed the crowds at BIGSOUND, NIMAS, Vivid Festival, Dreamtime, at the MCG and more with her deeply affecting music. So she's laying down a couple of R&B neo-soul tracks for us today, which demonstrates not only her vocal ability, but also her keyboard and guitar ability as well. And she's also joined by her band. So she's going to play three songs for us live, but the first one coming up is Hide and Seek, so stay tuned.
Perfect, you, yeah.
right. Good evening, everyone. We have special guests here, Bumpy and the crew. How are you all going?
Good. Thank you. Nice. Thanks for having us.
Yeah. Oh, man. It's a privilege. And to hear you in the studio was amazing. So we're very happy to have you here because as I was listening to you, it was like jazz and funk and soul and an infusion of all. And your voice, you make it look easy to sing, I swear.
Thank you.
How's she holding that note? Yeah. So, Bumpy, what's your real name?
Real name's Amy.
Amy, yes.
Bumpy is my nickname that I've had since I was little from just going full speed ahead and running into everything.
Yeah.
So now, it feels very, I really identify as Bumpy now. Yeah. Now whenever anyone calls me Amy, I feel like I'm in trouble.
That's okay. Yep. No, me too. But yes. Yeah. So tell me about the first song that we heard. It was Hide and Seek.
Yeah. Hide and Seek actually kind of lived before I really started doing a solo project, Bumpy. It was just one that I wrote. And when I decided to go out solo, finally found the place to take this song. And it really just is this light kind of playful track talking about like being flirty, being interested in someone. It kind of has taken many forms over time because we kind of play solo or like in the studio trio, but to the full band is 7-piece.
So, wow.
Yeah, so, it's a really fun one to manipulate often.
So you've got the keys, you've got the lead and the drums. What else is there to make up the 7-piece?
Bass, two backing vocalists, and usually I'm not on keys. We have the pro come in.
You're really good at it. And to be like a, what do you call that, multi-instrumentalist, that's friggin' awesome.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I was like, go on, girl. to sing and play is really hard.
Yeah, it is. It's a good challenge. I like testing it out a lot of the times and making sure I try and keep practicing the chops. But then sometimes it's really nice to have somebody come in and take that part and I can just focus on singing on top.
Yeah, because the breathing while singing, that's pretty hard. And then also you're like, oh, I've got to press this. I've got to hold this chord down. So, kudos, man.
Thank you.
Thank you for gracing and bantering with your presence.
Nevertheless, let's get to the next track, which is Leave It All Behind.
Pulls you in.
So, Leave It All Behind. Tell me, what's the story behind this one?
Yeah. This one actually was inspired by a camping trip because we were in Naarm during those, the time we don't talk about, the really hectic lockdowns. Mm. And, you know, they down there they had the full kilometer radius. You couldn't leave your house without a certificate kind of thing to say you're allowed and all that kind of stuff. And it was really tricky because, grew up, right next to salt water and bush. And so as soon as we could go back home and visit our family, we went on this beautiful camping trip and just set up shop by the water, mm-hmm. cooked on the fire, just switched off. And it wasn't long before we had to come back. And when I was back in the city, I was still just, my mind and my soul were still by the water. Yeah. And so this track is really about that idea of making sure, you leave it all behind and you switch off and listening to that calling that I know one day I'm going to end up by the sea, but trying to do the music thing and serve purpose in the city and enjoy that for all it is. But I still feel that and I still can hear that calling to go home and switch off.
Yeah, that would have been a nightmare to be in Naarm at that time. I have a couple of friends down there and they're just, no matter what was happening, if I was exhausted or, doing what I do here, I'd always make sure I'd check in with them because some of the conversations we were having as the massive lockdown went on there, it was very scary. And I just wanted to make sure that they were okay because I don't know how you did it. How long did it go for?
It's honestly just like a big bubble,
I think it was like 2.5 years or something. On and off.
At one point, we were really lucky because Ben actually moved into the house across the road from me. My pathway went into his driveway. So we were a bit naughty and we used to just sneak into each other's houses and share feeds and bunker down and you're hearing helicopters go around. And, it was quite intense, but we really improvised and
we just figured they were one house. There was just a little bit of a road in between.
Wow. We lucked out.
the only way we got through, I think.
Man. And so through that time living besides each other, how was your music and songwriting and your sound? Did it even change then throughout that period?
Yeah, I definitely think so. I mean, I was really lucky to still have a bit of work, whatever that looked like, lockdowns, doing all these different, lunchtime Zoom performances or the commissions where they'd said you to ride away and give you some gear to start working on your, recording space set up at home. And I think a lot of that really influenced the way I wrote, but also just the mindset, I think we all came out very different after that experience, just appreciating home a lot more and leading with that and putting that into our songs. I think it's kind of inevitable that it didn't influence. It did influence at all.
I guess the influence of that lockdown, then going out back home, back to your country, and going out camping, that it made it just more special, or the emotion that it took to write it and really feel it, because it was a massive time and then you're just free.
And it was just a sanctuary. I know I went around, me and Mick would hang out a lot and just have music as this space that, we couldn't get out, we couldn't go anywhere, but at least we could just jam. And you just really understood how special music is as a tool for you to heal and keep going and survive, and just connect to everybody else with that. We just have big jams and try and make ourselves feel good at that time. Oh, this run is actually unreleased and it's still in its formative years, I'd say. We're still playing it different each time. But this one was inspired by a mate who just outwardly expressed his love all the time for his mates, for his partner. Mm-hmm. And, he always talk about just it's so important to tell people right here, right now that you love them and why you love them. And sometimes I find that, really confronting. And I just saw him do it and I was like, you know what? I need to do that more. Yeah. And I'm going to write a Suki love song and, tell this person that I love them and why and, how special it would be to receive something like that. Shame job because Mick's here. So funny. Before we played in the band, I was like, I have to show the song that I wrote for you before I take it into the band. But, you know, it also just, yeah, it's important that we tell our loved ones how much they mean to us. And there shouldn't be any shame around that. If anything, like, I want to make sure we're all doing that for each other while we've got each other. So.
Okay, well, I can't wait any longer. So let's hear this next track. This is For My Love.
It was captured from the very start. We were shy back then before I gave you my heart. How will we ever know how far this would go? Coffee dates and cigarettes. When things got tough, you take my hand and say, of course it's alright. Let's just live in tonight. Finding the words I could never say, like how funny we knew we'd see this day. I can't pretend that I didn't want it back then. I can see clearer now that I'm with you. Oh, what a view.
Oh,
There you have it. I went into a bit of a dreamscape there. That was Bumpy, For My Love, such a lovely track. So if you've just joined us, we have Bumpy live here in the studio. And sis, I have one more question for you.
Who were your biggest influences, you know, and with sound and then also just teaching you?
I mean, definitely like always matriarchs in my family, like my nan and my mum are always biggest inspirations. They're such strong, staunch women, and you know, we grew up heavily in community and singing for all the aunties and the elders, and we still do that every Christmas, and that's always been our way of connecting, is like getting the guitar out and having a big jam. You know, that was so strong in my early influence of music, is just seeing music as a way to connect and a way to have a big sing together. Mm-hmm. And then when I really started to like be like, yep, this is what I want to do, you know, I was really into the big ballads of Adele and like fully down the line of singing at the top of my lungs. And then, you know, I really love Erykah Badu and Lauryn Hill, and kind of went into that big soul world and definitely have stayed there. But yeah, love like Hiatus Coyote, who were local in Naarm, and Jordan Mackay. And yeah, it's really beautiful to kind of see it keep evolving. And in the band as well, it's like super collaborative when we take the tracks in, and everyone's so amazing at what they do that it's nice to just have that influence and keep it alive. So I feel like I'm still learning and still constantly influenced by the people around me.
Yeah, that's beautiful. And thank you for sharing your time with us here at CAAMA today. And thank you for gracing us with your presence in the studio. That was awesome. Yeah.
Like thanks I said, for having
us. It's awesome. Three piece, let alone the seven piece. Hopefully we get to see you all perform, because I can't wait. That sent me into a trance like mode for the day. Yeah, I'm good.
No,
thank
you.
I need another coffee. Yeah. Nah, thank you all. Take care, and I'll be sure to see you on my travels as well.
Sounds deadly.
So well,
that's us on CAAMA.
Hey, come and check out the old CAAMA music I found.
From the archives.
Yeah, that's right. It's from the archives, where we here at CAAMA dig through our old CAAMA music library and find some tracks that may have flown under your radar or that you haven't heard in a while. We've got three songs coming up for you today. The first song is I Want You by Shelley Atkins. Shelley has been surrounded by music from a young age. Her father, Mark Atkins, is a nationally acclaimed didgeridoo player with many recordings and performances to his credit. Shelley was also the very first female artist to sign with CAAMA back in the year 2000 with her album Shell. So here we have I Want You from that very album.
And I feel so alone at night without you by my side. I get such a fright, and I feel
I want you, and you won't be too every day.
What a wicked song, eh? Very emotional, very raw. That was I Want You. Coming up next, we got Kira Voller with the song Rainbow After Rain. Kira is a proud Wirangal Kokata woman, with a number of independent singles and involvement with the NT's Desert Divas music program. She's also just come off the back of running music workshops for black women in music with Bumpy at the recent Ghost Gums Festival. Rainbow After Rain was released on her CAAMA Music album, Unapologetically Me, in 2020. There you have it, the smooth sounds of Kira Voller with Rainbow After Rain. The last song we've got for you today is called And That's Why by Crystal West. Crystal is a proud Piedram, Mambara and Paliwa woman. She found a national audience in 2014 after becoming a grand finalist on the popular Channel 9 TV show The Voice. She was also one of the 8 winners of the nationwide Alakura songwriting competition and has appeared on NITV's Our Songs. And That's Why was her single recorded with CAAMA Music back in 2015. Let's have a listen.
Goodbye, you're a child and I see the truth.
And there you have it, Crystal West with And That's Why. And that's it for the CAAMA Music Show today. Big thank you to Bumpy and her band for coming into the studio, playing some tracks and having a chat with us. And big thanks to all our CAAMA artists over the years. We'll be back next week with a special episode on local singer-songwriter Stuart Nugget. Same time, same place.
The CAAMA Music Show.
The CAAMA Music Show is produced, recorded, edited, and mixed by Lloyd Barrett and Brenton Woods. Presented by Shiloh Monkland and Jack Orr.